Hey and welcome to channel ShipItHolla. Here with me, Michael Hetrick. Today I'm going to be playing a few matches with Kibler's red-green aggro deck against Matt Nass's blue-white control deck. This deck's getting pretty popular and it's pretty good as well, so definitely worth playing again, and I like it quite a bit. So we've got the exact main deck Kibler played, and then for the sideboard we've come pretty far away from Kibler's deck. Burning Earth is, of course, the one thing that's definitely not leaving. Chandra is something a lot of versions of the deck started to play, even though I don't quite understand it. It's like another 4-drop, which, you know, Burning Earth is the 4-drop you want to have, so I'm not sure if it's exactly what I need, but we're going to give it a run anyways. Huntmaster I'm pretty fond of. A few matchups, the mirror match is one of those where it's pretty good. I've actually come to like Bonfire, but I don't have any right now in the deck, which is okay for this matchup because we're not bringing them in anyway. But before I play any Bonfire, I do want to have the fourth Mizzy Mortars. I just think it's better. But one and two Bonfire is still a possibility. Naturalize because the Hexproof deck is pretty difficult to beat without the card. It is possible, but and it's not that popular, but I do think it's something we should be aware of. Fourth Ooze is pretty good in a few matchups. And one Way Sand Viper, I like it in the mirror match, red-green aggro, and hexproof. Thought has been given to Deadly Recluse instead. That's definitely a possibility. They're both pretty fringe. I like them both as one-ofs only. Definitely decent cards. And then Pillar, you know, it's mostly for voice, but it's good elsewhere sometimes. Mirror match, you know, you get the one-drops or Geist, or sometimes other Huntmasters. So we're going to go ahead and get started with our first match. Alright, so looks like we lost the die roll. Though in these matches we're going to generally force whoever wants to go first. So probably back and forth. This is a fine hand, obviously a keeper. Though we're at our critical mass of lands already. So, I mean, if we're in the dark here, at this point we could probably assume it's red, white, blue. I guess we're Geisting since Geist is definitely better here. Since Flint of Boar gets better as a 3-drop. Syncopating. And in this type of matchup, though, we do want to resolve Domi Raid, obviously. So now we know it's blue-white for sure. Awkward. It's pretty good for him, while being on the play, at least. Okay, I'm not going to worry about Azori's Charm just yet. We're just going to play Boar Pass, protect Domri, play around Azori's Charm. I mean, really, we're not being aggressive at the moment, so let's see. And we're playing around Syncopate this way. Top cards of Mizzy Mortars. We're just gonna save our mortars. Yeah, I think we're just. His deck does play, I think, quite a few of the Oblivion Ring, but or rather the gold Oblivion Ring. I forget the name at the moment. So Domri's not really a surefire thing, but if we can get it up to 7, I think the game ends. He's gonna suicide one or have a Restoration Angel. He probably recognizes that he's not gonna be able to beat this. Oh, okay. He could also have Azori's Charm. That makes sense. Oh, that's really good for him, too, because he knows my card after the Boar is not a creature. Well, I mean, we just do it again. You just time locked us, I guess. Okay, looks like he was about to send him in again. Yeah, he's just if he has his Urush Charm, he's just time walking again. I guess if he has Snapcaster, it's a little better than a time walk. It's kinda pretty awkward. Like I could just let him Domri take it. I just can't though. It's like I have to make him have it. Make him use resources too, but we are getting nowhere. Yeah, actually, well, I guess we got to the point where we can cast this Rampager. Also means he has four spells in hand. And it would just be real nice if we could actually hit a creature off this. Well, could have. Then we wouldn't be necessarily locked. And he goes again. No? Yeah, you know what? I mean, I'm playing around Syncopate, but I can't really play around it forever, obviously. Like, it's gonna get something. I think it's better, though, to wait, because he may eventually want to cast something on his turn. Awesome. Well. We'll lock this in, that's fine. If he wants to tap out to counter it, I'm okay with that. And see, if he didn't attack last turn, we can assume he doesn't have Resto, unless he intended to hold it to get us with it. But Snapcaster and his Urush Charm, we could pretty much assume he doesn't have. We're just gonna play it safe. It's just a lot of things he could have, and he could also just think twice into one of them. Okay, so he did have the Resto. He might have been on that plan to try to get us. Or maybe, he probably wasn't. He actually just wanted to get the Resto into play so he could attack Domri. He wouldn't even want to trade it with a boar, or rather a Rampager. What's this? Aetherling? Okay. So we're gonna kill Aetherling for sure. We could overload this and then fight Boar versus Aetherling, so we would wipe out, three of our cards for his board. Definitely exactly what we have to do here. I'm it's a little curious that he runs the Aetherling there after we missed three times in a row on Domri. He's gotta know we have the mortars, and he's gotta know this is what we're gonna do. So it seems like he could have waited on that. So if we run Domri here, it gets countered. Think we wait. Since we know he has a verdict. Obviously he's gonna Revelation here. I mean, if he has Revelation, we're probably dead anyway, so. But if he's gonna Verdict, then we could resolve this. So you have to have six mana open. Ooh, interesting. That's really interesting. So now we can resolve this. And he won't even have a sphere necessarily. Wow, this is just the worst. Fourth miss in a row? He hit three times in a row on Augur. Or let's see, did he blink once? Four times in a row? Yeah, he hit four times. We missed four times. Got there. So, yeah, we're not going to concede yet. Technically, he could just have all blanks forever. No. That's impossible. Alright. Hawkeye would have been a good draw. Still would have lost, I'm sure. So in this matchup, Burning Earth is pretty bad. Just unplayable. Unlike other similar control decks. Chandra. I think it's playable. We'll find out just how good it is, I guess. And really, we don't have anything I like for this matchup. Huntmaster is, it's fine. It's probably better than something I have. But we're just overloading our 4-drops now. That's really it, though. That's all I want in this matchup. So Mizzy Mortars, we probably keep in one. And then after that, you know, actually, no, we just cut them all. Rampage is just better than Mortars, and that's the next card we're cutting. Yeah, it's just better. It kills essentially the same stuff, but it does more than just that. So, yeah, it looks okay.